So these are used to perform the same operation based on the condition. So let's see what are the different types of loops we have. We have do while loop and for each loop. So let's see one by one with an example. I'm just taking do while loop. Let's pull it out here. If you just observe, the structure of do while loop is something like it has a body and a condition. And flow of do while loop is first it will come to the body of the loop. It will execute the body, whatever the activities are there in the body, and then it will go and check for the condition. If the condition is true, then it will go again execute the body. Until the condition is false, it keeps on executing. Message box. Pull it here. I'm just checking this for example. Let's define I as an integer and this be in the scope of sequence, because if I give it in the body, I couldn't be able to access here for the condition. So that's why I have changed it to the sequence. So let's give a condition until I is equal to 1. So in order to increment this, we should take an assign activity, pull it over here and give I is equals to I plus 1. So this means first, if you have done the previous assignment, you will know here that the default value of an integer is 0. So I'm not giving any value for the I. I'm not defining any value. So it would take 0 by default and it will increment after every time. So first, the control starts from here. It will go into the body. It will print I. For the first time, it will print 0. And then it gets incremented. That means I become 1. So it will check for the condition. I is equals to 1. Yes, that is true. Then it will again go to the body. And it will print I, which is 1. And then it will increment, which is 2. But it will, but this condition fail here. So that's why it will come out of the loop. That's how do while loop get executed. It's a small example to make you understand. So 0, 1, and it breaks, right? So this is how do while loop works. Let's consider a while loop. So what if you just observe the difference between do while and while. In do while, we have body and then the condition. But in case of while, we have condition and then the body. So it's like first it will check with the condition. If its condition is true, only then it will go into the body and execute the. So the difference between do while and while is do while will execute at least once. But while will execute only if the condition is true. So let's execute the same piece of code. You can just copy this and drop it here. And then you can give I less than 0. So now I have went given any value, so it would be 0. So this will not execute the program. It will terminate immediately. So if you see, program has ended in 0 seconds. That means it didn't go inside the body. Let's say if I is equals to 0. That means it will execute only once. So it has given 0 and then that's it. So after incrementing, it will check again and I equals to 0, but I value is 1. So it will not execute at this time. So that's how do while and while differ from each other. Let's see what is for each loop. So for each loop is basically used to iterate over the collection of items. Let's suppose there is an array of strings. So if I wanted to print each value of an array at a time, then we'll go to each and element in the array until the items in that list become 0. So let's see how we can do that. Let's take an for each activity. So let's consider. So before to this, I have to take an array or a collection. So let me just take an assign activity. Here I'm defining an array. Which is an array of string. So let's change the type of this to an array of string. And now I wanted to iterate through an array. And I wanted to print every time. Let's check a message box and drop it here. And let's stay. So let's try to understand what does this mean? What did I write? So I hope if you're clear with concepts of data types and variables, you're clear with this one. Let's go into the for each loop. I'm taking variable array inside this. This means it's an array of string and for each item in variable array means at a time it will pick one item from the variable array. So what is that item? In the first iteration it will take the UiPath, in the second iteration it will take beginner, and in the third iteration it will take guide. So let's execute this and see the output. First iteration, second and third. So this is how the for each loop works. It will execute, there is no condition required. It will execute until the items in a collection become zero. So we are done with the loops. Let's take switch.